Hi. After the main sequence stars convert the supply of hydrogen in their cores into helium, they will transition into red giant stars. And these stars can be seen in a cluster like this, where we can see many bright red stars along with bright blue stars as well, and many, many fainter stars. So if we think about the HR diagram, we see the blue stars are main sequence stars, and the red stars are not main sequence stars, they're red giant stars. And so if we look at the main sequence stars on the HR diagram, for stars of various masses, as they age, they will transition off the main sequence. This happens as they run out of their supply of hydrogen in the core. Once the hydrogen in the core is exhausted, the core fusion stops. The core temperature is not hot enough to take the helium that has been fused and converted into other elements. The core collapses because the pressure cannot balance gravity. This collapse causes the now pure helium core to heat up. So if we see here, the Sun as a main sequence star is very small compared to the Sun as it will be 100 times larger when it is a red giant star. The process will take place for the Sun in about 5 billion years. During the red giant evolutionary phase, the star is very large, so its surface gravity is quite low, and it is so bright that the radiation pressure, the light pressure pushing out at the surface, is strong enough to slowly push the outermost layers of the star into space. This stellar wind, similar to a very strong solar wind, produces a significant mass loss during the giant phase. So similar to what happens on the Sun, but much more dramatically for a period of time. Hydrogen in a shell surrounding the hot helium core also then heats up, and a new stage of hydrogen fusion will begin. And this begins at the beginning of the giant phase and at the end of the main sequence phase. And this is the reason the star expands. It's because a shell of hydrogen fusion around a core of pure helium forms. This is what we call a giant branch star. So the Sun will expand to become a red giant about 5 billion years. The core will be pure helium. The fusion of hydrogen into helium will occur in a shell surrounding the core. So this depicts the solar system, the Sun in the center, and it will expand out, filling all of the orbit of Mercury and some of almost out to the orbit of Venus during the red giant branch phase. And so the core will have helium, and there will be a shell surrounding the core, which is converting hydrogen into helium. And the core is very small near the center, or in the center of the red giant. And the red giant continually gets larger as time goes on. This is not a steady state. It will expand and continue to do so. If the helium core in the giant star continues to contract until eventually it's hot enough to begin a new set of reactions, the fusion of helium into carbon and oxygen, this is the process of core helium fusion. and it begins suddenly. This event is called the helium flash. So as the we see the main sequence here on the HR diagram, and remember the top right of the HR diagram is for stars that are very large, and the bottom left are stars that are very cool, because very small, because these are cool and very bright. And if they're cool and bright, they have to be very large in order to maintain that brightness. So as the star leaves the main sequence, this is just one example, and it does depict the future of the sun. We follow the evolution up here as the star expands and becomes red, and then the helium flash occurs when the core contracts to a point where it can fuse helium into carbon, and some oxygen is also formed. And so the outside of the star, the majority of the star expands while the core contracts. Core contracts and heats up, star expands and cools down. And so we see the star is red, yet the core is contracting and heating up to many millions of degrees. When the helium flash occurs, the core temperature is about 100 to 200 million degrees. We can compare that to over here when the core temperature was 10,000 degrees. Remember, on the HR diagram, this is the surface temperature always. The core we can't see, but we can tell that from models and that the core temperature is about 10 million degrees here and about 100 to 200 million degrees there. So even though the star is cooler on the surface somewhat, it's much hotter in the core. And this is when the fusion of helium begins. And this is called the triple alpha process. This is because historically a helium nucleus is called an alpha particle. And if I've got three alpha particles, four helium nucleus, they crash into each other to become a carbon 12. And what happens is first one happens and then the next one. And these will often wait and then break apart. But if the third one comes along quick enough, then the fusion will take place and you get a very stable carbon 12 nucleus. You get energy in the form of light. The energy in the form of light is gamma rays, the highest energy radiation. Now, the helium flash does not happen to all stars. If the star is below about two solar masses, then helium fusion begins, but not with the flash like that. And the helium flash on the HR diagram is seen here. This is a globular cluster, M5. All of these stars are the same age. The stars in the main sequence, most of them are gone. In this part of the main sequence, down here, we have the remaining main sequence stars, but others have become giants. This is the red giant branch. The helium flash is at the very top of the red giant branch, and then it comes down for the horizontal branch, as we see here. And so, in a different diagram, and this is actual data, but now in a diagram showing that, we see the horizontal branch over here. So we have the main sequence phase, we have the red giant branch phase, we have the helium flash, a very short event lasting just a few hours, and then the horizontal branch. Remember that we can talk about a star moving on the HR diagram. We're not talking about its motion in space. We're talking about the change of its properties. The two properties, specifically the temperature and the luminosity. Brighter on top and fainter on the bottom, hotter to the left, cooler to the right.